students, now we will be discussing about learners with specific learning disabilities. So the term specific learning disability means a disorder in one or more of the psychological processes involved in understanding or in using language, spoken or written, which may manifest itself in an imperfect ability to listen, speak, read, write, spell, or to do mathematical calculations. Learners with specific learning disabilities exhibit a disorder in one or more of the basic psychological processes involved in understanding or in using spoken or written languages. They include conditions which have been referred to as perceptual handicaps, brain injury, minimal brain dysfunction, dyslexia, developmental aphasia, etc. Now coming to the assessment of the learners with specific learning disabilities. An ideal assessment for specific learning disabilities is a long process requiring several sessions with a qualified education psychologist. Apart from administering a battery of tests, the psychologist also gathers relevant information about the child from the teachers and school records. The child must be assessed in all areas related to the suspected disability, such as health, vision, hearing, social and emotional status, general intelligence, academic performance, communicative status, and motor ability. Now coming to the test, various tests are available. First is reading achievement by Swaroop Mehta, Niemann's battery test, visual motor perceptual measure by Gestalt test or screening test, checklist of learning disabilities is there. Auditory skill test can be done by Woodcock. Psychoeducational battery test done by with the help of the tool developed by Woodcock and Johnson. Grade level assessment device for children with learning problems in school, GLAD, by Jayanti Narayan from NIPIT, formerly known as NIMH, Second Report. Now coming to the supporting learners of learners with learning. Instructions should be brief and as simple as possible, allowing the student to use tape recorder lectures, clearly defining course requirements, for example, like the dates of the exams and when assignments are due, providing advance notice of any changes, providing handouts and visual aids, when appropriate, teaming a reader with a non-reading student during in-class assignments. Using more than one way to demonstrate or explain information. Having copies of the syllabus ready 3 to 5 weeks prior to the beginning of classes so textbooks are available for them. When possible, breaking information into small steps when teaching many new tasks in one lesson. For example, strict objectives, review previous lesson, summarize periodically, allowing time for clarification of directions and essential information, providing study guides or review sheets for exams, providing alternative ways for the learners to do tasks such as dictations or oral presentations, allowing the use of spell check and grammar assisted devices. When in doubt about how to assist the student, ask him or her. Allowing the student the same anonymity as other learners, that is, avoid pointing out the student or the alternative arrangements to the rest of the class. Now coming to the classroom management of the learners with specific learning disabilities. Some of the tips for the teachers: break learning into smaller steps. So any activity should be broken down into small, small steps for the better understanding of the students with specific learning disabilities. The teachers should administer probes to the particular specific learning disability, supply regular quality feedback, use diagrams, graphics and pictures to augment what they say in words, provide ample independent, well-designed, intensive practice, model instructional practices that they want learners to follow, provide prompts of strategies to use, and use of AT, that is assistive technology, is a very helpful step for understanding or managing students in classroom with specific learning disability. Now, what is assistive technology for specific learning disability? In general, assistive technology compensates for a student's skills deficits or areas of disability. However, utilizing assistive technology does not mean that a child cannot also receive remedial instruction aimed at alleviating deficits, such as software designed to improve poor phonic skills. A student could use remedial reading software as well as listen to audiobooks. In fact, research has shown that assistive technology can improve certain skill deficits, for example, reading and spelling. Assistive technology can increase a child's self-reliance and sense of independence. Kids who struggle in school are often overly dependent on parents, siblings, friends, and teachers for help with assignments. By using assistive technology, kids can experience success with working independently. So that is all about specific learning disability. Now, summing up this particular unit. So an intellectual disability is a disability that significantly affects one's ability to learn and use information. It is a disability that is present during childhood and continue throughout one's life. There are four types of intellectual disabilities: mild, moderate, severe, and profound. Some of the general characteristics we have to remember of children with intellectual disabilities are delays in oral language development, deficits in memory skills, difficulty learning social rules, difficulty with problems with solving skills, delays in the development of adaptive behaviors such as self-help or self-care skills, lack of social inhibitors. To make teaching and learning effective for learners with intellectual disability, an individualized education program, that is IEP, should be prepared to meet the individual need of the child, as every child is unique and needs are specific. Effective classroom management techniques should be maintained. Specific learning disability means a disorder in one of or more psychological processes involved in understanding or in using language, spoken or written, which may manifest itself in an imperfect ability to listen, speak, read, write, spell, or to do mathematical calculations. An ideal assessment for specific learning disability is a long process requiring several sessions with a qualified educational psychologist. Apart from administering a battery of tests, the psychologist also gathers relevant information about the child from the teachers and school records. Some strategies are suggested to enhance accessibility of course instructions, materials, and activities. They are general strategies designed to support individualized, reasonable accommodations for which a student is eligible. So that's all in this video. Thank you.